You are so free, Millie. But not advanced. Whereas Kate is so constrained and yet advanced to a high degree.
So you did come to see her?
Isn't that what you wanted?
Where's Millie?
Gone to get ready for a drive.
You're going with her?
With your approval.
My approval's complete. I don't think I'll wait.
Swear that you love me.
Here? There's nothing between us here.
Isn't there?
Look, look. Tell her finding you with her, I wouldn't wait. She'll understand. Was that Kate?
Yes. She's gone. She didn't know she'd find me here.
I'm sorry.
Don't be.
We don't have to.
Let's go.
And yet your face is changed. You love her, but she refuses.
And so all the doors swing open. I am suddenly invited for the evening to Lancaster Gates. A soiree. I don't know what for. Millie will be there. Nothing's changed. Nothing's changed for me. I love the girl. I love Kate. That's all.
Mr. Densher.
Good evening.
Do be at ease to sit. We're going to have the most intimate evening. Our American friends, you know.
Yes, indeed.
Good evening, Mr. Densher.
Good evening, Miss Croy.
Here's Millie.
I need to speak to her.
Where's Millie? I'm afraid she's not well enough.
Millie's not coming.
Susie, what's the matter? Let's go into the drawing room.
Millie's not coming.
Are we allowed to speak with each other?
She won't leave us for long.
Is she ill? Tonight? No.
But is she ill?
Her doctor says the greatest thing for her is to be happy.
That is surely the greatest thing for everybody.
But what if she can't be?
She must be. She will be.
They're supposed to be leaving town, but they've pulled since you...
Don't be ridiculous.
She doesn't know whether she'll see you again. The future has opened up a dark, confused thing.
I thought she was this great success.
There's a shadow.
What shadow?
She sees Sir Luke Strett.
The famous doctor.
It isn't the case she first supposed.
You've made Millie change her mind.
It's another...
examining her for what she's supposed.
He found something else.
She's scared. She has so much to lose. She wants more.
What do you think of
Mr.
Densher?
She can't have everything.
I like him.
If you can imagine an angel with a thumping bank account, it's open to her to make a great...
She won't be magnificent if she marries him.
But isn't it magnificent to marry someone you like?
I shouldn't get her if she hadn't so much.
Did you really just say that?
I shouldn't trouble with her, except she has nothing.
She must have everything.
She does love life. To meet someone like you.
Me?
The way she looked at you.
Then she's a fool.
To love so freely.
Yes.
And she makes no arrangements.
You handle everyone.
Not like you.
I don't handle Kate.
I use what I have. You're what's most precious, and you're therefore what I use most.
You mean Kate cares for him?
Kate thinks she cares, but she's mistaken. Deny to Millie that she so much as thinks she does.
I believe that if she's ill, she's really ill. She'll really live, or she'll really die. She doesn't want people to know, I don't know. It's intensity of...
It's a pity he isn't better.
Well, if he were better, you would like him for your niece.
Oh, I don't like him for Kate. I like him for myself.
So you want me to make up to a sick girl?
Plenty others will.
Others are free.
So are you, my dear.
You always have some way to meet me. How could I look at another woman?
You draw me out. I exist in you. Don't fail me, it would kill me.
Mr. Densher? Come drink coffee with me. Kate, show Susie my new tapestry. I've hung it, but I'm not sure it's the right situation. So, you will go and see our little friend again?
She's leaving town, isn't she?
We shall go with them. To Venice.
Then I won't see her at all.
You'll come out to us. Millie has taken a palazzo on the Grand Canal. I'll write to you.
Thank you.
This could be the occasion of your life. Do not lose it. I can smooth your path. Her fortune is a real fortune.
I'm obliged to you for the handsome offer.
Of what doesn't belong to me. But there's no reason it shouldn't to you. I've told a lie for you.
What lie?
The proper one.
You've told her that Kate doesn't love me, haven't you?
Now I depend on you to make it right.
Venice, end of summer. Shadows lengthening. The first glimpse of the lagoon, the smell of it, that liquid level edged out by domes and spires. Sea and sky meet halfway. Look, a palazzo floats, staked above its small island, approach only by water. Its windows low enough for you to glance towards. And there, half a reflection, a young woman, pale, ghost, for a moment stares back at you. No, beyond you. Outwards she looks, onto her different world. The young woman. Look at her again. Her reflection on the water disappears, reappears. She's frail, half transparent, stricken, desperate to live.
Son, so stirred on the water, blinds me, catches these pictures and relics. I cannot stop walking backwards and through it, this palazzo that is momentarily mine. That is so still. The voice is all gone away here. Now, most of all, this city speaks to me.
Venice and its invitations of streets and views. Secrets, doorways half flooded. It may have a great deal to give this city, but it will demand return. A street plunges away, leaving the edge of a shelf that is broken only by water.
I could lose myself here.
Easy to lose yourself, to turn and not know which way. Shadows, people, fleetingly cross your path and then half seen, half heard, your breath, their last echo, trap you in this city, this tomb. And still she stands, this young woman. Could she find her way? Could she live?
An hour alone, they, Maud, Susie, Kate, gone. They in their loud voices, I don't care where. Absorb, amuse, detain them, drown them, kill them, if you will. So that I may just for a moment see where I am. I will never leave this place. It will stay here and float on and on.
Who is it? Who's there?
It's me, Mark. I'm so sorry, there was no one.
But Mark, did you come by gondola?
Well, you didn't see me.
I was...
Is anyone else here?
The others have...
I was just...
...gone to look at old churches.
At Carlsbad. I was a bit bored. A bit blue, I suppose. Knew you were all here, so I thought...
How did you know we were here?
Well, our friends.
Maud.
Kate.
Wrote to you?
Of course.
You could catch them on the Rialto. They just left.
Oh.
Why are you here?
Oh, I would rather...
Or the Bridge of Sighs.
Look at this great temple of taste. Oh, what a palazzo. Here, walk me round it.
Why are you here?
And yet it was a home. Like a possible but forgotten life.
I don't think I ever want to leave.
You don't go out, then? Not at all?
No. I just go about here.
So you're not well?
Why are you here? What value do I now have? None. Nothing. Is that my value? The ravage of my disease? I might not last. But my money will. Is that your plan?
Millie.
I would not marry you even if I were penniless. Your cold eyes, and yet... you half smile. I think you are my
friend. I think it's a wonderful place to go about in.
I don't want to give it up.
So you'll live here?
I think I'd like to die here.
Oh, now that requires picking. Can you buy it?
I might. But if I get it, I'll cling to it.
Then you will be alive.
Not quite extinct. Hiding.
Are you really in trouble?
You mean am I badly ill?
I can't watch you suffer.
You won't see me suffer. That's why I love this place. It's so out of the way. You won't know anything about anything, and you don't. Not even you. I am very badly ill.
And you don't do anything?
I do everything. I can't do any more than live. The best advice. I'm acting on it now. I can't do more than live.
Oh, live.
Well, it's immense to me. I shan't have missed everything.
Why should you miss anything? Since you believe in advice, take mine. I know what you want.
I want not to be
worried.
No,
you want to be loved. It would worry you less if I mean you're not loved enough.
Enough for what?
Why, to get the good of it.
You mean the full good of being forced to love you in return?
Is it so inconceivable?
To be favorably affected by
you. To believe in me.
To try, you mean. In return for your trying.
I shouldn't have to.
As a healing and uplifting passion, it is in truth deficient. You don't want to marry me. Or go with me where I go, there will be no winning.
You think I couldn't do it? Or be what you need?
Do you?
Anyway, I don't believe in the seriousness of what you tell me. It's too absurd. If you can't get the right doctor, who in the world can? Oh. We're all in love with you. I put it that way, dropping my own claim if you can't bear it. You were born to make us happy, so you must listen to us.
I can't listen or receive or accept. I won't make a bargain. You must understand that.
But you must want somebody.
You shouldn't have come to Venice to see me. You have much older friends.
Who?
Your best friend?
Miss Croy?
Maud.
Oh, you want me to marry Maud?
No, of course not.
Well, who then? Kate?
Maud wants you to.
And Kate, does Kate want me to?
She is the most clever, handsome woman I ever saw. If I were a man, I would love her. In fact, I do love.
As do others.
There is no one else.
So you really don't know?
That there is a... certain man very much in love with her. I know.
And that
yes.
She is very much in love with
You're
that man.
Wrong.
You're sure?
I speak on the best authority.
Oh, Maud.
Kate.
Well, from Kate herself.
I take it from Kate.
That she's thinking of no one.
No one at all.
She swore.
She left me in no doubt that she was free.
And thereby in no doubt of your being too.
Yes.
But why, then, is she having to swear at all?
Because she is my friend.
Oh, it... Oh. You have another visitor on the canal. Tell me his name again.
Palazzo Leporelli, signore.
Grazie.
Prego.
Merton Densher.
Did you know he was coming?
No. Yes.
I must go.
It's like a museum. A palazzo. I look like a fool coming in like this.
Mr. Densher!
Hello? I hope you don't...
No, of course not. Come through the passageway, then up.
This is spectacular.
Isn't it?
I can't quite take it all in.
Look up.
No words.
And the water? Always... laid right by.
The way you welcome me. Your frankness, your sweetness, your sadness.
I can see everything. Everyone going by.
Your brightness. Like disconcerting. I don't know. Poetry somehow.
It's beautiful. And you in it.
Everything shimmers. Like faint snatches of sound. Ghosts. Music. Somewhere close by, but not...
Did you just arrive?
Yes, well, I went to my hotel. It's full of...
What? Americans?
Well, I suppose I wanted something somewhere more, I don't know, Italian?
Hmm.
I stayed here before. It was a place a bit further down the Grand Canal. Shabby, but high ceilings. I don't know, it had this sense of mystery. Ridiculous, I know. Green shutters. I liked the...
Green shutters? Do you think this all too grand?
Well, it is certainly...
Ridiculous. Say it.
It's like a museum. But not dead. If you know... I don't know what the word is. Is there a word? Somehow, I don't know it. It stirs my imagination. It hovers.
It sits off in me a whirlwind of suggestion that never stops. The freedom of all the centuries built into these pictures, these... The plaster look and the...
Somehow we float.
Yes.
It's like being under a spell.
Lily! Good afternoon, Mr. Densher.
Good afternoon.
We just met Lord Mark. He nearly walked into us.
Yes, he was here.
He said he won't stay, that he was just passing
through. He was just passing through.
Oh. He looks a little ruffled.
I must go. I think I will go down and see about those rooms.
Well, you'll come to dinner.
I will. I would like to.
Good afternoon, Mr. Densher.
You place me here, Kate, You, it's perfectly done, but what for? Your pure talent for life. Do I do everything you say? Do I come to Venice, meet with Milia? I have no will left. I have done everything you wanted, everything, but what have you done? Where have you? Nothing, whatever. That I need proof, Kate, of your love. If I could find it, if I could keep...
Do you mind he's here?
Who?
Mr. Densher.
No, not at all.
Really?
No. I don't feel anything for him. I told you. Well, slightly irritated.
Why?
Because he will steal our days away. You from me.
He won't.
He will. He will. He didn't come here for me, Millie. You know that. He came here for you.
And suddenly I am afraid of myself. That I might, that I could, that we, Kate, here, we might find a way to make our love possible.
beautifully.
Am I?
You're wonderful. You're beautiful.
Think I'm happy?
You don't seem unhappy.
Don't I?
What time is it?
We have 10 minutes. We've time yet.
We must at least walk towards Maud and Susie.
They're still in the shop.
That shows then.
That they trust us.
That they believe in you.
What's wrong with Millie?
She didn't come down to breakfast this morning.
What does that mean?
That you miss your time together.
There was such a hush in the palazzo when I called this morning.
There's still a hush. Don't you feel it?
So Millie is ill?
She's wonderful. I've told you that.
Can I ask you something?
Anything, but let's keep walking.
Why was Lord Mark at the palazzo the other day?
He came to make Millie an offer of marriage.
And she declined?
Well, that's why he left so quick.
So when I turned up, that was what was taking place.
So you are in love with her.
And what does Maud make of Lord Mark's offer?
He's not committed to us. He was having his try.
I thought he was committed to you.
He's had his try at me.
And you refused him?
I didn't let it come to that.
What then?
I discouraged him.
You treated him beautifully.
Oh, you're jealous.
I take from you what you give me. Only you know what you give me. It seems to me to be
what?
Less and less. There's so much you don't give me.
What don't I give you?
I give you proof that I love you.
What proof?
I'm here, aren't I? You give me nothing.
I'm doing all of this for you. Do you call this nothing?
What are you doing for
me? I risk everything.
You risk nothing. I love you. All this I do because of what we are, who we are to each other. That we, when we met, we understood each other.
We ought to be there. I mean, when they come out.
They won't come out yet. I don't care if they do. Let's be done with all this. Let's just face the music. Break this.
We can't.
Then tell me what you risk.
You.
What?
I risk losing you.
You won't lose me.
You are here, but not here. You are half mine.
Let's stop this then.
We've gone too far. Do you want to kill her?
Aunt Maud.
You know who I mean. We've told too many lies.
I've told no lies.
Oh, thank you for that.
Millie's my friend. That's all. If you think I've lied, then I'll go this very evening.
Go then. Kate, how was the lace?
Exquisite. Mr. Densher, Maud demands coffee.
Florian's, I'll go and help her secure a table.
I'm so glad you're here, Mr. Densher.
Is Millie ill?
No, she's marvelous.
So she'd be with us for dinner, then?
She'll come down after dinner. There'll be a little party. Sir Luke Strett has arrived from London.
The doctor?
It's for him she wants to do something. So I hope you'll...
Stay?
Tonight. There's to be music.
Why has she sent for Sir Luke Strett if she's not worse? Hesitate, and for one moment I let myself see that she might be ill.
He was coming from the first for his holiday. There are things I would like to say to you.
Say anything?
No, I don't want to spoil. Will you stay?
After dinner?
Beyond that.
Well, I have to think about work and...
Of course. Do you write about Venice?
Do you?
No. I would, but... I have completely given myself up to...
Millie?
Yes. To her.
This is my world now. This palazzo. These faded frescoes. This is everything.
You come down after dinner in a dress so white, it's like I never saw you before.
I'm sorry, I missed everything.
You're different, fairer. I don't know, your hair so red, so ripe.
You look wonderful, by the way.
Thank you. Meanwhile, unfortunately, I must acquit myself as hostess.
The one thing I hold in my mind is that we met before all this, that this isn't Kate's idea. It is your idea and my idea.
Do you think her good enough now?
You know how good I think her.
Everything suits her. Look at those pearls. She's a dove. You don't think of a dove as bejeweled, but they suit her down to the ground.
Down to the ground is the word.
Pearls have such magic. They suit everyone.
They would suit you.
Yes. I see myself.
And I see you thinking that pearls, those pearls, are the one thing I could never give you. Married to me, you could not be more different than all this. Is Millie better?
No. She's worse, but that's nothing to do with us.
Nothing to...
We're making her want to live. Tonight, she wants to live. It's wonderful. It's beautiful.
It is beautiful.
She's doing it for him. The doctor. She wants to be for him at her best, but she can't deceive him.
Nobody is deceived.
No one.
Then tell me, how can it be right for me to make up to a girl who is dying?
It gives you time.
For what?
For anything that might happen.
You mean something in particular?
Yes.
That you think possible?
I do.
Something that is for you as well as...
Yes. Put it together. If you want things named, then name them.
Since she's to die, I'm to marry her.
To marry her.
So that when her death has taken place, I shall, in natural course, have money. That's what you always meant.
You shall, in natural course, have money. We shall, in natural course, be free.
Oh. Should I just propose on the spot?
I can't go into that. You must act as you like and as you can.
How can you be like this?
You have a free hand, a clear field.
Proceed to business under your eyes.
We shall go.
Go.
In a day or two. Maud wishes it.
Then what becomes of Millie?
She stays, and you stay too.
You leave her to die then?
She doesn't believe she'll die. Not if you stay.
And what if she doesn't accept me?
You can only try.
I would have to try very, very hard to propose to a dying girl.
For you, she isn't dying.
I look round at Millie. I can't help myself. And she, catching my glance as if she feels me, smiles. Don't smile. As if you know of what we speak. As if you know everything. The luster of your pearls, the value of your life, all this.
You've turned pale.
I might stay without trying.
To stay is to try.
Without you.
Without me.
And you leave when?
Thursday latest.
How can you bear this?
When you know me better, you will find out how much I can bear.
I don't know you at all. She's my friend.
You do love her.
You'd risk everything.
Merton.
How can you ask me to do this?
I love you.
No.
That's why I ask you.
I'm leaving. I'm leaving tomorrow.
Don't talk.
There's never a place, is there? No place where we can just love each other, is there?
There is one place.
Where?
We could be alone.
My rooms?
Before I leave.
And afterwards?
You stay here, with Millie.
Don't come to me for the money.
No. I come to you for love. I want you to remember me. I want you to remember each part of me. Inscribe me on your mind. Inscribe me on your body.
No one may come here but you, Kate. This place, this room, I shut you in.
I must go.
No, not yet. You are in all of my poor rooms. I keep you here,
don't
my love.
Let go of me.
And now you linger here. It lives again. We live. Me Now, in my constant communion, no, not communion, immersion, if I sit very still, I can hold you.
I fade in your arms.
You are all in my poor rooms.
I unravel in my absence.
You're still here. A ghost.
Hold on to me.
A breath.
I'm despairing.
My room's so quiet now. So empty.
I'm already gone. So far away.
What's left? I wake to your silences. I run away from your nothingness. At the palazzo, you are completely disappeared. You and Maud gone. A fleeting memory. Away, back to London.
Why did you stay?
To write.
You'll do your book here?
I hope to begin.
You haven't begun?
Just...
since you came?
I've broken some ground.
We've made a mess of your time.
I'm hanging on to repair
the mess. Don't mind me.
You'll see how little I mind anything.
No, I mean if you want the best part of your days to write...
I'll make do with the worst. The best will be with you.
I could visit you at your rooms. So you could work.
Is it safe for you to leave the palazzo?
Safe? You think me so bad?
I think whatever you tell me.
I'm splendid.
I know that.
I'm capable of living.
I don't doubt it.
I want to live.
If you want to.
I will.
I believe that.
I can.
You will.
So may I visit you?
Will it help you to live?
I don't want to miss anything.
The rooms where my love was, where I hide in her memory. Must I let go of even that for you, Millie?
You can come whenever you like.
Sorry. It's no matter. I don't want to drive you away.
You won't drive me away.
I don't want to come.
You can do anything
it's
you
over.
Want.
It's over. I
You're
didn't
free.
Complain.
I know you don't complain.
And now about your book.
Oh, I'm not doing a book.
You're not writing?
I don't know. I don't know what I'm doing.
Then it's not for your book.
I'm staying.
I ask too many questions. You stay because you've got to.
Isn't it enough to stay for you?
There's the lie. I stay so little for you. And yet...
that you must judge.
Somehow, I don't know, it doesn't matter. I do stay for you. We're here. Just us. This is the whole world. To hold on to you. It is the only way I can stay faithful to you. But you have completely disappeared from all this, gone from my poor rooms, gone from the grander ones in Millie's palazzo. It is like you were never here. Here, Millie is everything. Her house, her hospitality, her character, and still more. Her imagination.
Good morning.
Good morning. I want to show you something.
Where are we going?
Come up. An old library. I found it last night like it was hidden, like it was waiting.
All these books.
Half dust.
Carved up and hidden away.
Half pink, half...
It smells like a... like an old chapel.
I don't think anyone came up here.
So many books.
Italian history is mostly, I think I daren't touch them. Look at the ceiling in the corner.
Cherubs.
Half falling away.
And all this looking out onto the water.
I slept up here last night. Couldn't sleep. I came up here for a book. I lay on this couch. Stood. Defy sleep. Defy oblivion. I hung out the window, looked at the stars. Here. Everything became so true, so as if to light up the whole of life and make everything clear. At dawn, I stared up at these old ceilings, all red and gold. So they go on forever and ever, and suddenly everything became so still I could hardly breathe. All I could hear was the water of the canal, then without knowing, I slipped the sweetest sleep.
Sognavo di casa. Adesso sogno solo del mare.
What does that mean?
I used to dream of houses. Now I dream only of the ocean. Of here. I could kill her.
I am mixed up in her fate, and she mixed up in mine.
One false move. I must not move. Keep still. No vibrations.
I love this courtyard.
I could sit here all day.
No one comes in. No one comes out.
Come down.
No. I have the best view up here.
Yes, but can you smell the flowers?
So much it hurts.
You are right.
Don't pick them.
You don't want any.
No. Let them be.
I found something else.
What is it? What is it?
Grapes.
Is that a grape?
It used to be. No, I didn't mean it. Is it? How is it?
Dry?
Oh.
Many pips? Sharp? Disgusting?
Give me one.
Don't do it. No, you don't have to.
Would I ask you to do something I wouldn't do myself? Smooth. Very chewable. Too chewable. Slightly fermented, I would say. Disgusting. You wouldn't think there's a world outside.
That's
of
why
here,
I love this city.
More than New York.
More than New York. Am I allowed to say that?
More than London.
You can hide here. In plain view.
You could be forgotten here and it wouldn't
no
matter.
No one need pass your door.
No calling cards.
I hate calling cards. Why can you not go to someone's door or just knock? The element of surprise. It's all so exhausting, so polite, so boring.
I was watching some street kids kicking a stone around. It was simple, easy. Venice was part of them, and they, Venice. They wouldn't let me play.
Oh, do you mind being stuck here?
I'm not stuck. Even if my editor called me back, I wouldn't go. I... He wouldn't find me. No one knows where I am, and I don't care. All this, I like being nowhere, being nothing. Somehow I can't explain it. It's like here, there's this whole other world that doesn't work by machinery and manners.
It's somehow possible. I feel that too.
Yes, like you said, we float.
Just to be with her, that's the thing. Not for profit, not to... Just to remain near. We laugh. Kate and I, we never...
Where am I?
I know this street, do I? Everything's so familiar, yet...
Which way? Is this the old bridge I've walked over 100 times?
Is it? Or am I somewhere completely different?
Signora, vorresti una gondola?
No, no, grazie. We sit.
You know it's the tide. That's why everything keeps changing.
Every day the city's taken apart and put back together again. You're cold.
A bit. I like it.
Don't.
What?
Get cold.
Why not? Night is the real time in Venice. To feel it. Feel the chill of it. Everything becomes mysterious.
Have some more grappa. You mustn't let it go to our heads. Look, the sky is so bruised tonight.
I think everything's gone to my head. I said to someone once, I didn't think I could be more alive than I was in that moment. I was wrong. How can a person not live? I have no defenses left.
Good morning.
La signora is not receiving.
Beg your pardon?
She is not receiving.
Is she ill? Amalata?
I cannot say.
Something happened. Is there some message?
No message. Good day.
And there is no invitation to return. There always is invitation to return. Something's happened. The sky breaks. The shock comes. And here, on Piazza San Marco, the grand drawing room of Europe, I see him seated in Florian's. Lord Mark, yes, look up at me, recognize me, face me. Look away, pretend you don't see me. Is it because of you? Because of you, Lord Mark, this storm, this, that the palazzo is closed to me. There you sit. Have you done what you came for? You have been to see Millie. Now her door is shut to me. You just drop in, descend, invade, brutal. You can't. Did you propose again? Did she turn you away? She doesn't want you. She, we, and so you hurt her, you. What did you say? I'll wait. I'll wait. Some sign will come. I'll get a note. I'll go home. I'll wait at home to get it. It might be there now. No message. Nothing comes. 3 days. I think of you, Millie, in your palazzo, in your silence, the cold breath of your reasons wishing me to go away. 3 days. I stay, in spite of your silence, in spite of my disgust, in spite of some final meeting that will be unbearable. I stay in spite of what Lord Mark might have told you, in spite of everything, in spite of nothing. I stay here, alone.
Who is it? Susie, let me take your umbrella. Please, please.
Millie has turned her face to the wall.
She's worse.
I don't know what she is. That's why I've come to you. She hasn't spoken.
For 3 days?
Nothing. As if it was all over.
Is she dying?
Then you know.
Yes. I know. And you know.
Yes.
Everything.
Not everything. That's why I came. She doesn't want to die. Think of all she is. She lies there, clinging. I think it would kill me if she would tell me.
Tell you?
Of what harm you have done to her.
Would she see me again?
Do you want to see her?
If she'd bear it, I'd do anything.
There is one thing you can do. You know what it is.
What?
Deny it to her.
Deny what?
What Lord Mark told her.
What he told
that
her?
That you've been all the while engaged to Miss Croy.
I saw him in the piazza through the glass at Florian's. I knew he wouldn't have come for nothing.
He doesn't know what he has done to her. Only we.
She hid that she didn't know.
She showed nothing.
And he...
Idiot of idiots. He meant no harm. He intended none whatever.
He, of course, meant only harm to me.
He was humiliated.
Yes.
He saw you. You were received whilst he was turned away.
And I stayed on with her.
Precisely.
And it was just revenge. Didn't he know? See her, feel her, judge her as perhaps not having more than a few months to live.
He was doubtless been aware. As you yourself have been aware.
He wanted her, you mean, just because?
Just because.
Shall we have lights, a candle?
Not for me.
Nothing?
Not for me.
Where has he been since here?
London.
With Maud?
I think so.
He will have proposed to Kate, and she will have refused him.
You being clear to him as the reason?
Not so clear as I'm here. He must believe I may have a reason in London, and yet been up to something.
Up to what?
Some game, some duplicity.
A monstrous supposition. Will you deny that to Millie herself?
Are you sure she believes it?
Judge.
Do you believe it?
What I believe will depend on your action. Settle it, and I will believe you down to the ground if you save her life. If you deny it to her.
Deny what?
That you're engaged to Kate. That you're in love with Kate. All of it.
A fortnight. Without sending me a word.
Yes. Have you any news? From Venice?
Up to within a day or two.
Is Millie still alive?
Don't you know?
She's dead.
No.
Not yet.
It must be very terrible.
For her, you mean?
For you.
I don't matter. But I don't think that... Though I try, I can quite tell you what it was, what it is for me.
I can believe how dreadful it must have
been. Has Sir Luke Strett gone back to her?
He's there now.
Then it is the end. He won't leave her. He'll stay. He's magnificent.
I think she's magnificent.
Oh, you don't know.
She is my friend.
You would be sure of that, would you?
Of course I'm sure.
So what do you think of Lord Mark's news, then?
Lord Mark?
You haven't seen him.
Not since he saw her.
So you know about all of it?
All of what?
That it was his visit, that she couldn't stand, that what took place, what he said. She turned her face to the wall. She gave up all power to care again. That's why she's dying.
Oh.
He told her that you and I are secretly engaged.
He doesn't know that for sure.
It doesn't matter. She did by the time he left her. Our idea was she might never learn it, wasn't it? That we'd convinced her that there was nothing between us, at least on your side. That's what you told her, after all.
Yes, I told her. So it wasn't through anything you did.
Wasn't it?
It wasn't your idea.
Let's not go into that.
Couldn't you have denied what Lord Mark said?
To tell her he lied.
To tell her he was... mistaken.
Ah, we still engaged?
Of course we're still engaged. But to save her life...
It wouldn't have done any good.
What, you mean she wouldn't believe you? Did you try?
I didn't get a chance.
She wouldn't see you.
Not after Lord Mark.
Could you write?
I told you. She turned her face to the wall.
So you never met again?
No. We met. Once. She sent for me. I went to her, and afterwards, that night, I left Venice.
Couldn't you have denied the story then?
She was dying.
Because she was dying. But, of course, I know that. Seeing her, you could judge.
I did judge. I did see her. Moreover, if I had denied you, I would have stuck to it.
To convince her?
To convince you.
To convince me?
I wouldn't have made my denial and then taken it back afterwards.
You'd have broken with me.
I couldn't have done anything else. So you see how right I was not to commit myself. And if it ever appears to you that I might have done so, remember that.
You've fallen in love with her.
Well, then say so. With a dying woman, why need you care, and what does it matter?
Wait till she's dead. Why did she send for you, then?
That's what I've been trying to work out. I thought it would give me a chance to deny, but she never asked me. She never mentioned it.
She never wanted the truth. She wanted you. She loves you. Just to see you, then, for one last time.
She thought I'd gone away. But then she found out I was still there. It moved her. She said that if it was somehow for her I was staying, she wanted it to end. She wanted for me to know how little there was need of it.
That you mustn't wait to see her die.
That I mustn't wait to see her die.
Did she receive you in her rooms?
In the great salon. In the dress she always wore.
So it was almost happy?
I don't think I can attempt to say what it was.
Shall we have tea?
Shouldn't we wait for Maud?
Oh, you needn't mind now. We've done it.
Squared her.
You've pleased Aunt Maud.
What a brute I must be to have pleased so many people.
The great thing is that Millie is satisfied.
Satisfied? To die in the flower of her youth.
At peace with you.
Peace?
The peace of having loved.
Is that peace?
She realized her passion. She has had all she wanted. Sugar?
Nothing.
You may think it hideous to say now, but we haven't failed.
Oh?
We've succeeded. She won't have loved you for nothing.
Don't.
You won't have loved me. Here's Maud.
I want you to be in no doubt, you poor boy, that I am with you to the end.
I am so sorry I haven't...
been to see us. I quite understand, my dear, that the shadow, the sorrow of it, marks for you an impossibility of company. I'm surprised you didn't stay with her. You couldn't stand it.
Couldn't stand.
Kate or I would have stayed if we hadn't, of course, left.
I have no doubt Miss Croy would have stayed.
Millie is stupendous.
What stirs me most is how the poor girl wants to live. Why couldn't she, with everything to fill her world, the mere money of her, if it is too disgusting at such a time to mention?
Okay, I have to go.
You're dead. Pretend you're dead. It's the only way I can bear this waiting, this ache. It cuts my breath. I can't eat. I can't. I don't.
No!
I can't have anything to do with this. I can't think of you conscious.
No!
Suffering.
No!
Don't.
can't. What can I do? What can I do? This is nothing to do with me. It's over. It's all. I would have stayed. You asked me to leave. It wasn't for me to stay. If it's over, when it's over, I can become good again. I can become something at least for somebody. I'm good for nothing like this. Nothing. Least of all, you. But there is one thing. One thing I can do.
Got my telegram.
What's the matter?
I wanted us to walk in the park like we used to.
That's all?
It's everything to me. Take the old paths, turn as we did. Stop, start again.
Let's walk then. As we did. Remember our seats under the trees?
When no one saw us.
It doesn't matter now.
I have moments.
What?
Thinking that I don't know if I will ever again be as happy.
As when we met in the park?
Yes. That sounds ridiculous to you.
No. It sounds lovely. But I have hopes. Of our high happiness now. We only have to be patient.
I have none of that left. We played our game, we lost. We owe it to ourselves and for each other too. To not wait another day.
For what?
To marry. Don't you see? I see it so clearly. It will right everything that's wrong. It will, it will.
Will it?
I can't tell you. My impatience, If we only announce it, then I feel I could breathe again.
Announce it when?
Tomorrow. Then nothing matters. We'll be right. We will be all right, strong. Put away these past fears. All this will be like a bad dream.
Love, what has happened to you?
I can't bear this any longer. That's what's happened. Something broke in me. It's as I am that you must now have me.
But... what's changed?
How can you ask me
that? We've been going along so well. Now you desert me.
So well.
Well, I call it perfect. I am where I was. Give me some reason for your not being the same. Nothing's changed. What's between us? We only have to wait.
Wait?
Unless you already know something.
No.
But have you heard something? Because if you can tell me you know...
Well?
I'll do what you want. We needn't wait. I can see what you mean by it being nicer that we don't... I don't even ask you for proof. If you're sure...
About what? I know nothing.
You've no idea.
She's still living.
Is she?
Have you heard something?
Nothing.
I know nothing.
I see that.
Everything's changed. I remember that one night, Millie. You couldn't sleep. You slept at the top of the palazzo in that little library. You stared at the stars. I defy sleep. I defy oblivion, you said. It's so strange now. This night, this endless night, suddenly I can't feel you anymore. It's like you slipped away, so completely gone. And your absence, your sharp absence, like a knife cuts my heart. This oblivion stays with me. It's in me. I can't defy it. I have no... I wait for dawn. I don't sleep. Maud.
You came too?
the doctor home?
Sir Luke is not here yet.
I couldn't wait.
He arrives travelling straight tomorrow. Early.
It's over, isn't it?
Our dear dove then has folded her wonderful wings.
I knew.
Unless it's more true that she has spread them wider.
Last night, suddenly...
For flight, I trust to some greater happiness. Should you be alone? Merton, this evening, dine with me.
Do you mind if I don't tell you now?
Not in the least. Leave it open. Otherwise, I shall sit alone. Kate has returned to her family. We differed, and when Kate differs with you, she has the misfortune, I suppose you know, to have a terrible father. Too bad to name. Well, he has shrieked for help. Money always, but also for safety from God knows what. She's gone to him. Come if you can.
I can.
Where would you go?
I don't know. There is no place now. No place to find you. Don't leave me here. Oh, God, don't leave me here. Please.
It's so strange. I feel so many things in seeing you in this place.
My father called to me. I came.
He's ill.
Oh, he's never really ill. He's only endless.
Why did he call you here?
He's terrified.
Of what?
I don't know. Somebody, something. He wants, he says, to be quiet. But his quietness is awful.
What does he do?
He cries.
What has he done?
If you love me now, don't ask me about my father. You didn't want to come here, did you? You look terrible. Like you've been tortured. Are you not well?
I'm well.
You hate what you're doing?
It's not as simple as that.
You haven't decided what to do.
I thought I had. Only now. The sight of you here.
Horrible, isn't it?
I received a letter.
From who?
Postmarked 3 days ago.
From Millie.
She wrote it on...
her deathbed. There was never anyone in the world like her.
Yes. There was never anyone in the world...
Is it in her handwriting?
Yes.
Its usual look?
Beautiful.
Where is it?
It's here.
You brought it to show me.
I brought it to show you.
But now you're here, you don't want to. You haven't read it?
I haven't read it.
Then what do you want from me?
There's something you didn't tell me the other day.
What other day?
How did Lord Mark know we were engaged? How did he find that out? His coming back to Venice and telling Millie.
You think I told
him? Did you?
I refused to meet him as he wanted me to meet him.
I don't know what that means.
Should I have given him an answer that would have kept him from going back to Venice? Should I have said I would marry him?
Did you
him?
Know he was going back to Venice?
No. But I would have given him the same answer.
And what reason did you give him? Only you and I knew about our engagement. You told him, didn't you?
You must have seen something.
No. He asked you, and you let him see.
I hesitated.
You never hesitate.
I hadn't heard from you. I hadn't.
You set me a task to stay there. How could I write you letters? What could I say?
I thought I was losing you. He saw that.
You told him we were engaged.
He was no longer deceived. But he came back convinced. I mean, after he saw Millie.
Millie?
That it was her you loved. She told him that.
She convinced him.
I love you. It's because I love you that I'm here. It's because I love you that I've brought you this.
You haven't broken the seal.
It's for you to break the seal.
To break the seal of something from her to you.
Because it's from her.
You don't need to read it. This is the proof.
What do you mean, proof?
Of the beauty with which you have been loved. I won't break your seal.
You decline.
I know without.
And what is it you know?
She has made you rich.
Left me her fortune.
Not all of it. It's immense. But money? To a large amount.
Did she tell you?
Never.
Take it.
You want me to take it?
In Venice, you were capable of an act of such splendid generosity. For that, I give you this. This is yours.
My reward?
It's everything I feel.
You've had to do yourself violence, haven't you? To do this.
So it is here at last you meet me. Take it.
You absolutely desire it.
I absolutely desire it.
To do what I like with.
Yes.
To hold it is to know.
Oh, I know.
Well then. We both know. If we both know, I don't need it. I'll place it on the fire. You'll have it all from her lawyers in New York anyway.
I see a man, a young man in Venice, so far off, hushed, scared, staying his breath, half understanding, dimly conscious of something immense happening and holding himself so tight so as not to lose it. He hesitates outside a glorious palazzo. He goes up. He goes into that glorious sitting room. She is there.
Millie.
Every part I have gathered, I can't coherently say. It was like something huge, like ice, like fire, at the same time. It was a dove, the lightness of light itself descending inside, outside of me. Is the word forgiveness? I don't think there is a word enough. Whatever it was went through every sinew. You went through me. Or was I transparent? I saw the young man for the first time. I felt the air touch my face and you. You. And now. Something so rare moves in me here in my room, something that is mine, that I will never, can never share.
Dear Merton.
Again and again.
My dearest Merton.
It is that I will never, never Merton. Know what was written in your letter.
Do you remember the first moment?
I know your intention, but...
I love.
Your words.
The money is the least part.
The way you shape.
Dear Merton, my dearest Merton. Merton.
The things you would have said to me.
Is it true? I know it's not true. It doesn't matter. My dear Merton, I love you. I always. Doesn't matter.
I never will see your letter. Read your letter. Yet I keep it so close.
I knew. I didn't know. I always knew.
My mind fills it, refines it, rewrites.
I am in the library.
Millie?
It is like watching a priceless pearl cast into the sea. No, more than that.
My darling Merton, it seems so strange to write these words. I didn't write these words. I didn't ever say not to you. Out loud. How I wanted to live. I want to live. I'd have done anything. Not to miss any of it.
All of it. This.
It becomes like a vibration.
Not to miss you.
Like a wail.
Us.
That is the sound I seek in the stillness of my rooms. I guard it. I seek it. I am one with it. Until the sounds of life course go away.
Are you ill?
No.
Smother it.
I received the letter from New York you sent me. I broke your seal this time.
It's not my seal. That's what I meant by my note.
That it's mine?
Well, it's theirs. The lawyers in New York. We might have sent it back without breaking the seal.
You're going to refuse it. Aren't you? Her money?
Yes. Don't you think I should?
It has nothing to do with me.
It has everything to do with
How?
You. You don't think I should give it up.
And still you don't want to know how much she has left you.
I don't want to know.
If I was in your place.
What do you know about my place?
Won't the facts be published?
Where?
In the papers.
I'll escape that.
You want to escape everything?
Everything.
Without knowing how much you ask me to renounce?
I know it's not meager.
It's worthy of her. It's what she was herself.
Stupendous.
Stupendous. I think that's what it really is. You're afraid, aren't you?
Afraid?
Of the truth. If you're in love with her without the money, what will you then be with more? You're afraid. It's wonderful to be in love with her.
I was never in love with her.
Not whilst she lived. But the change came when you saw her that last day. She died for you that last day so you could understand her, could see her. And you did. You do. You see everything. She did it for us, you know? I used to call her a dove. Well, she stretched out her wings to cover us.
Yes, they cover
so
us.
So that's what I give you. That's what I've done.
So you agree?
To marry you without the money because you won't marry me with it?
You lose me, but you lose nothing else. I'll sign the money over to you, every penny.
So I must choose between you and the money.
Yes. You must choose.
What about your choice?
What choice?
Promise me you are not in love with her memory.
Her memory?
Don't speak of it as if you couldn't be. I would be in your place. And you are one for whom her memory would be enough. Her memories, your love. You want no other.
I'll marry you, though. In an hour.
As we were.
As we were.
We will never again be as we were.
Thank you. The Wings of the Dove by Henry James, dramatised by Linda Marshall Griffiths. Henry James, the narrator, was played by John Lynch. Jodie Comer was Millie. Nico Mirallegro was Merton. And Aisling Loftus, Kate. Maud was played by Emma Cunniffe. Susie by Christine Bottomley. Lord Mark by Jack Lowden. And Butler by